It's time for your daily crypto update with Framework Fortune. I'm your host, Ben. Now let's dive in. As you can see on the chart, Bitcoin has made a little rebound here recently on the 4 hour. It has gotten back above the 20-day moving average, but it is not bullish yet. This could be another pullback coming as we are below these other indicators. We need to see Bitcoin break above the 50-day and the 20-day cross above. We start seeing the 20-day cross these other indicators, we could see Bitcoin go bullish again and maybe go on another run. But I still think we need another day or two to see if this is going to be a true rebound or just a bounce off of some lows. Now, looking at Ethereum on the 4 hour, we can see that it rebounded some but is running right into the 50-day moving average. That's going to be some decently strong resistance, and then you also have the 200 and 100 day right here at 3000. So for this to go bullish again, we're going to need to see this 20 day creep across these other indicators. And we look at it on a daily chart, you can see where it's bounced off this 200 day moving average as support. 200 day moving average has the most data because it's data from 200 days, so it's going to be strong support and strong resistance. So as much as Ether crashed, it got bought up every time it came down to the 200-day moving average. So right there was a good buying opportunity. Now all the moving averages are where they are supposed to be. It's just the price needs to get back above the 20-day, and then Ether will be fully bullish again. But that being said, right now the market is very volatile. So if you're day trading or short-term swing trading, there are definitely some profits to make. One that I've been saying to watch is Cardano. And you can see on the 1 day it started popping back up and it's crossed the 50 day and getting close to the 20 days. So this is very close to being bullish again. And we look at a 4 hour chart, you can see how close right here the 20 day is to crossing over these other indicators. But if we don't get a crossover, then ADA will sell off. Dogecoin still trying to pull it together. It is above the 20 day, but has these indicators above it. Same kind of situation on the daily chart. It is below the 20 days, so we need to see Dogecoin get back over 40 cents, 45 cents maybe here soon. Polygon-matic, another one that we've been watching for weeks, and some of us made some good profits on it. I know that I did, had the big sell-off, but as you can see, it found support at that 50-day moving average. So it's bounced up over the 20 again, so we're now bullish again at the moment. We go into a 4 hour chart. The 20-day is about to cross over the 50-day. So we're very close to having another breakout on Matic here soon. We could see it back over $2 if nothing drastic happens with Bitcoin. So as long as Bitcoin can hang around in this support area or start climbing back up, all of the cryptos should get back to some type of groove like they had before this big crash, because not all of them was running exactly together. Now they all are kind of really close. Give it a day or two. Let's make sure that these gains hold and that these cryptos consolidate and start making their way back up. And towards the end of the week, we'll start doing some more live crypto trading here on the Framework Fortune Daily channel. And remember, if there's any coins you want covered that I'm not currently covering on a weekly basis, leave them down in the comments below. And think about subscribing, joining the Framework Fortune community. I'm your host, Ben. Appreciate everybody. As always, stay safe out there. Until next time.